Amanda Gorman, everyone, has been on the tongues of people across the nation as our inaugural poet, but I'm just excited that spoken word finally made it to a national stage.
Obbie, let's break it down. Spoken word poetry, it is an art form that I know you have been a part of for absolutely many, many years. So what is spoken word?
First, that's a long, that can be a long answer. Spoken word, first off, it's liberation. It's therapy. It's a bullhorn. Mm-hmm. It's like a broadcasting system for society. It's a way to translate information that some people may not understand when it's coming from another type of source. It's a voice box for those individuals who don't have voice boxes. So we kind of speak on behalf of those who can't speak for themselves. So spoken word can be a lot, is a lot of things.
It is. You know, a lot of people don't understand the roots of why marginalized communities even use spoken word or where that came from, but we weren't allowed to read and write. And so our history, our stories came orally. Like what does the historical context mean? Even now, when we hear that inaugural poet, a black girl getting up there and speaking spoken word, like bringing that message in that form, what is the impact of that?
With spoken word being like the soul food of expression, you know what I mean?
Oh, I love that.
When you take all the things that are left over, because you can't have those privileged things, and you take what's left over and you make something out of it, and now it'd be going from the soul food of expression to like the gourmet meal of expression, I think it came a long way. And for her to be able to showcase on that platform, I think it put the rest of the world on alert that spoken word is absolutely relevant. That it's not just relevant for entertainment, but it's relevant for education, that it's necessary. So now I think that this pushes us a little bit further to being recognized on those same platforms with other genres of art, like R&B, rap, and whatever else. I think it pushes us a little bit closer to doing that. So it means a ton.
It does. I'm glad that you said that, because like spoken word, in my opinion, has always been kind of like an underground art form.
Absolutely.
It's always been something that, you know, you find in your coffee shops, you find in your libraries, but you're not gonna find on a main stage, you're not gonna find usually on a Broadway stage. And we've struggled, right, trying to find that identity.
What just happened at the inauguration was absolutely amazing in terms of us being able to push past those barriers and be on a major national stage. So what does it take? Right? When you get that, when you're like, you know, I'm about to sit down, I'm about to write a poem, what does that take for poets to transition into mindset to be able to get down and start to infiltrate and write the information that people need to hear?
It takes vulnerability, and it takes absolute fearlessness, because at the time, during that writing process, it's pretty therapeutic, right? Because the paper normally doesn't have a say-so. It doesn't reject anything that you have to say. But when you know you're writing it to broadcast it to society, there may be a tendency to not write it as unadulteratedly, if that's the word, as you would like to. Mm-hmm. So it takes that vulnerability to be able to say, I'm gonna write whatever it is that I feel, and I'm gonna present it, and there's somebody out there that needs to hear it. Those people that need to hear it, they'll receive it well. There's the level of vulnerability, a level of liberation, a level of fearlessness that has to exist.
I like that you said that, fearlessness, and it is. It's a bold representation of like the inner you, and it takes courage to be able to like put that out, right, for other people to see, unadulterated, if that's the word we're gonna coin this time. It really is. It is a way to kind of just completely let go and let people see the inside of you. One of the things I love about poetry, especially spoken word poetry, is that it shows people often the hidden parts of themselves that we are too afraid to see. And for the poet to be able to be the mode in which that happens, there's some work they have to do on the inside, right? There's some recognition that they have to have when you're looking at your environment and you're interpreting it. You've got to be able to have like a really, really keen sense of understanding of the world around you to be able to really hit those hidden parts of a human being. So when you walk into a room or you walk into an environment, what are some of the things poetically you pay attention to that like end up finding themselves in your writing?
Tough question. Good question, though. I think what it is a lot of things aren't understood when they're just said, right? They have to be painted. So when you just say something, sometimes it doesn't really translate well. But when you paint that thing and the words become visual, it becomes a little bit easier to understand. So for me, I try to figure out ways where there's a common message that doesn't seem to be getting through. And maybe it's not getting through, not because society is rejecting it, but because society doesn't understand the message. So let me figure out a different way to say that message that may be a little bit more digestible, that may resonate. And at that point, it's kind of like if I have a candy bar and I'm reading the nutritional facts on the candy bar and it says this candy bar will make you fat and kill you, I'll eat the candy bar while I'm reading it. That doesn't scare me, right? But if I go to the doctor and I'm diagnosed with diabetes and they say you may die, instantly I'll change my diet. So data is never enough. But when you add emotional aspect to that data, then it becomes a call for action. So that's what I think of poetry is. Poetry is the emotional aspect that we add to the data that now makes people want to go forward and act. So I look for ways to add that emotional aspect into situations that may not have it, if that makes sense.
Oh, man. No, that does make sense. I've always told people that poetry is the intangible world. Like, we live in this physical world that we can touch, that we can define, that we can, in some ways, quantify. And we can, there's barriers, there's modes, there's a form to it. However, poetry, for me, is everything that you see or that you experience when you walk into a room that you can't touch, that you can't see. That's the emotions, the feelings, the energies, the everything else. And what we do is we take all of that and we add words to it so that we can interpret it in a way that you can receive it and understand the duality that is happening in the same exact space that you're present in. And I think that's absolutely beautiful. So for someone who is interested in spoken word or is like, man, look, I was inspired. You know what I'm saying? Like, how do you start?
Wow. First, I would say you're going to quickly realize that spoken word is a large depiction of what you've been through in life. You'll find that subconsciously the catalog will be composed of those things that you have been through in life. So one thing that I would say is be ready to be vulnerable. Second thing I would say is be inspired by that person, but don't become the person you're inspired by. Have your own voice, be unique. Don't fall into the accent of poetry to where everyone sounds the same. So be inspired, but don't conform, if that makes sense.
Yes.
Maintain your identity throughout the process. Understand that everything you say isn't gonna be popular, but it's your opinion. So it's just as relevant, whether it's popular or not. You own it, so it's just as relevant as anything else. Don't try to conform to the popular topic. Just say those things that are relevant to yourself and go for it.
I love it. You know, in the poetry world, we snap, you know what I'm saying? When we hear something like dope, we be like, you know, give it some snaps. So let's snap it out. Thank you so much. Breaking it down, spoken word poetry. Listen, if you are a writer or if you're someone who has some sort of insight into something, you want to get it out. You got an opinion. You got something you want to say. Get it out. Use your voice, whether it be on a national stage, whether it be at the local coffee shop or in front of two friends on Zoom. Make sure you let your voice be heard. Thanks so much, Obbie, for breaking it down. Let's snap it out, right? Snap it up. Thanks so much. I appreciate it.